Hi there, good evening, welcome back to Creator on Wheels, and I hope you guys are doing happy and healthy. It's a weekday, it's a Thursday evening, I think time is around 6 p.m. One of those rare days when I didn't have any meetings late in the evening or in the night. So I decided I'll just come out and get some fresh air and go for a short ride. No agenda, no destination in mind, but just wanted to take out my bike, that's the whole thing. But while I'm doing that, I thought I'll just quickly talk about a couple of incidents that happened last week with me. One thing is when I was driving in my car on the way back home from Basanudi, and another incident which happened when I was on my bike and I was going out with my family. Two incidents which was like kind of related, but I thought I need to talk about it. So probably I'll take this time now to explain what really happened and my thoughts about it, and probably share some information with you. Having said that, just maat maatali karyakramada hosa sanchikege ellarigu aadarada swagata. To give you a precursor about what I am talking about, as much as we are careful when we are riding or driving and we are going out, we are very cautious about the speed, we are very cautious about the riding gear that we wear and all those things. One thing that my father has taught me, which I'm really happy and I'm something which I follow every single day, every single time I take my vehicle out, irrespective of whether it's my cycle, my bike or my car, is that you need to be very attentive about others who are riding around you. So driving careful does not always mean that you should not overspeed, you should not do this or you should not do that, but it should also be about attentiveness. Quite often when I'm out in group rides, or even for that matter when I'm out with my cousins or family, when there is like multiple cars out, the general assumption is that I drive a little slow. I'm typically the last person to reach the destination. I'm okay with that because I'm very cautious about the people who are on road. It could be like the bikes which are on my left now, the car that is on my right, or the vehicles that are coming behind me. I'm extremely cautious and aware of what's happening around me. Because when something bad happens, it's not about your mistake. It's not that you go and hit someone, you were riding rashly or you were overspeeding or anything. It could be that the other person is doing it and you are at the receiving end. So you need to be very careful about that. And it all, I would probably say it comes by, I don't know if I should really call it practice, but you need to be in a situation wherein you should be able to read what's happening in that other person's mind, how they are driving, what they might be doing. And as all of you know, one of the most unpredictable guys are the auto guys, especially when you are within the city. But auto things aside, because within the city it's very rarely that you are driving fast or they are driving fast, but I'm talking situation wherein a little bit of speed is involved. Now, going to the first incident, this happened last Tuesday, and I was with my mom and I was coming back from Basanudi. It was in the evening. This place is like just after the Uma Theatre Junction, when I'm coming towards the railway station. Typically, I've seen that in this junction, there is a lot of traffic, and I've been driving in that road for like 7 days before that. Every single day I was driving past and there was a lot of traffic. And on this day, Tuesday, there wasn't much of a traffic, but I felt like something strange. Like it was all about, like as I told you, intuition about it, like it was something strange. I crossed the Uma Theatre Junction. I was in my car, as I told you. It's coming straight. I was heading towards this junction, which is very famous for like this traffic jam. There was an auto which is coming from my right hand side, and he came all the way to the middle of the road and he stopped. I was very cautiously having a look at is like the way, like, will he go, drive past me or will he stop and all. Because if he had decided to drive past, and if we both had maintained the same speed, very likely that I would have hit him. But he decided to stop immediately, and he gave an indication that he will stop. So just when I was about to cross him, the auto is on my right hand side, he had completely stopped, and there isn't much of a vehicle behind or in front of me. Just when I was about to cross him, like, I am in line with the auto driver, I just went front by a head by 2 or 3 feet, and I saw that a lady who was driving her two-wheeler, probably one of these Axis or Activa, she came in very high speed, very, very high speed. Like, I'm pretty sure for that road and for that junction, she's probably double the speed. She just came, and I think she had this blind spot because of this auto. She didn't know what is happening on the left, and I was not at all aware that there is something coming from behind the auto. She just came, and I don't know, she probably put 1,000 times of her effort, and she just applied the brake, and she just stopped probably about 1 inch or maybe 1 centimeter away from my car. And she was like in a very, very good speed, I'll tell you. If at all, if she had not braked, very likely 3 things would have happened. A, my car would have got damaged pretty badly. Her front of her vehicle would have got damaged pretty badly. Those 2 things are okay. Yes, I'm telling it's okay. But in that speed, at that impact, I'm pretty sure she would have fallen off the her bike, and she would have got injured very badly. Now, whose mistake is this? I don't want to comment or anything about it. She is coming from a crossroad, and she is entering a main road, and there is an auto in front of her which is already stopped, and there are vehicles which is coming from the other side of the auto, which is a blind spot for her. I'm not trying to justify that I was right in driving past when the auto stopped, or should I have stopped and all those things, but if at all, if she was not attentive, or if she had not taken that decision to brake, the things would have been really very bad. There isn't much I could do about it, as much as I am aware when I am driving, but it would have been a really, really bad accident. And the worst thing is what happened after this. She stopped, and I, like, even I stopped, because, like, the moment I saw the bike, and I just immediately applied brake. Those are not the situation wherein you try to accelerate. Like, I immediately braked, she braked. And I just saw in my mirror, she is not at all bothered about what happened there. I mean, I didn't wanted her to ask sorry, nor I wanted to get into a fight, because there is no reason, because if she had touched, then the situation would have been really different. Not that we would have gone to the fight, but her situation would have been bad. But she was not at all bothered about it. And both me and the auto driver, the expression on our face was like petrified to the power of 100. It was really like both of us thought she would have hit me. And I just put her first gear, I moved front. She literally sneaked through between the gap of my car and the auto. The auto guy is still standing. Sneaked through, and she just continued to ride fast. The confidence for her was like next level. And I think she felt like nothing happened at all. Nothing really happened at all, like that she told. I mean, nothing bad happened because she was able to brake. But I'm telling you how mentally you need to be prepared. Like, at this point of time, like, I don't know, just like as I told you, like, if I had slowed down or I had, like, drove fast, things would have been different. But the moment I saw the auto guy stop, my car speed changed slightly. But I don't know if it was for good or bad, but at least I can say that it was good because nothing bad happened. But you need to be very, very attentive. You don't know what will happen. And I'm like, even now when I'm talking about it, I get scared when I get reminded of that incident. And the amount of confidence with it, she's like, she didn't even bother seeing me or seeing the auto. I think the only thing that was running in her mind was like, why is this car guy still standing when the road is empty in front of him? She just drove and she actually went fast again. So So attempt number one, what I'm trying to say is be very attentive. Like, it's not about your mistake, but there might be a situation wherein it's somebody else who might be in a bad mood, somebody else who might be riding rash, fast or whatever, which might result in something bad, which is not good for either of you. So be very attentive. Now, the second incident happened on Saturday, just like a week back, again last week. Me, my wife and my kid, we were on my Dusky. We were on the way to Vasanpuri again. Not really Vasanpuri, I would say like Vivipuram. And this was pretty close to my house. This is on the Sheshadripuram College main road. It's in the evening, around about this time, maybe like 6:30 or 7 o'clock-ish. And I was not, and it is an empty road. I was not driving fast because, especially when I have somebody with me as a pillion, and more so specifically when I have my kid with me, very rarely that I ride fast. Because I am worried about their safety and all the stuff. We wear helmet and all those things, but still, I'm very cautious about that. As riding, and I mean, I don't know, I don't remember the speed, but I was definitely not fast. Out of nowhere, just immediately after the Sheshadripuram College entrance, there is a road which is on the either side of the college. From the other side, there's a Baleno which comes in like full speed from left to right. He's like literally, I mean, I don't want to exaggerate, but probably he was in like 60, 70 or more, probably even in 80 on a crossroad, and he's entering a main road. As I told you, I was very conscious. I was looking at what's happening around me. I could see that he didn't even bother turning to the right and seeing if there is any vehicles coming on the main road. He just wanted to go past that main road. He was fast. And the moment I saw him, I started, like, I don't generally use the horn much, but in such situation, I just like go bang on my horn. Like, I just like press and hold it so that it gets the person's attention. Almost after crossing half of the road, he turned right, and then he realized there are vehicles coming from the right, and he applied brake. Okay, and I'm in such a situation that if I had continued in the same speed, very likely that I would have gone and banged him right in the middle of the car. So I had to slowly drift to the right. Okay, and all thanks to he taking the decision of slowing down and stopping, and me taking the decision of slowing down and parallelly applying slow brake. I didn't want to suddenly apply brake because it'll just throw us out of the bike and it's even more disastrous. And there was no way I could have like tried to speed and go in front of him or behind him. It wouldn't have happened. It happened like when my bike stopped, when the car stopped, we were just like 1 inch away from each other. Literally 1 inch. Either of us had not slowed down, I would have definitely hit. It would have been a really disastrous evening. And again, what happened after this is important. The guy does not even bother to say sorry or anything. He rolls down his window and is like, "Boss, why are you coming so fast?" And I'm telling him, "Was I coming fast or you?" He's like, "Yeah, you're coming fast. You're driving too fast." I told him, "You are doing that. Forget about me being fast. Irrespective of whether you're fast or slow, you are entering a main road from a crossroad. You're supposed to stop and see to your right and left and then cross the road. You didn't even bother about it and you're crossing." He's like, no, you are fast. At this moment, by this time, there were at least like two cars, or like an auto and a car, who were just behind me, who had also stopped. They started blasting at that car guy. They told him, like, "Is that a way to ride?" They were like not bothered about me having a close call with that car guy, but these guys also started showing their hand. I was like wearing my helmet. I didn't hear what those guys were telling, but the moment the other guy started shouting at him, he got embarrassed and he's like, yeah, fine. And he just like drove us. And again, he didn't even bother telling sorry, yeah, it was my mistake and all those things. He just like he just went past. I don't know why people do this. Like, I don't know. Like, there were other people in his car. I think there were like somebody in the passenger seat in the front as well. I'm not sure if he was engrossed in talking with them or if he was distracted or maybe he was fighting with them, that he didn't concentrate about what's happening in front of him. Because I know I can probably bet about this, and you can directly quote me on this. If you are not in a good mood, there are very high chances that you will drive fast. It's not just the road is empty and you have a good vehicle that you ride fast, but even when you're in the bad mood, you tend to drive fast because of all that blood pressure and the mindset that you are in. Okay, so in that way, I would say be extremely cautious about what you're doing, when you're doing it, and how you're riding. Think about people around you also. Just imagine, like in the first incident, that lady would have got hurt really bad. In the second incident, we three, like me, my family, we would have fallen off the bike, and like it would have been like really bad situation for we three. The vehicle damage, it can be repaired, it's not at all a big deal. But what about people? So be extremely careful and cautious when you're on the road. See, it happens just like this. That was one live example for you guys. I don't know what to say. People are just not bothered about what is happening around them. They just want to go, they will go. They want to drive fast, they will drive fast. They want to cross the road, they will cross the road. They don't care. And in past, whenever I was going out of station, me and my friends, we always used to say, like, I am a person, probably I would have done 90% of my traveling in my life. Whatever I've done in the last 10-15 years, I've done 90% or maybe even 95% of it on my car. If it is something within Karnataka, I always take car. But one thing we are always cautious, like when you're in village side, right? Like, people just tend to cross the road. They just want to cross the road, they will cross the road. They don't care whether a car is coming, a bike is coming, at what speed it is coming, whether it's a state highway, national highway, nothing. They will just cross the road. So you have to be very conscious, and there is nothing you can do if you hit them. Game over, I'll tell you. So be very cautious, be very attentive. As much as possible, try to be cautious about what's happening around you than just about you. Like, you sometimes you might feel like, okay, this is an empty road, I want to go at 100, I want to go 110. My bike, my car allows to go faster. Try to analyze, like, take 1 or 2 seconds, try to analyze, is it a good road to do that? Will there be any risk? What is the potential, like there might be a speed breaker? What is the chances that somebody might cross? Or what is the chances that there is a blind spot in front? Most of the times in the roads which we travel every single day, or probably would have traveled 100 times, surprises happen there. So be extremely cautious and attentive when you're driving. That's all I wanted to say. I know I spoke a lot. I tried to go very deep and very granular, but I had to say this. Am I a perfect driver, or I'm a perfect rider? No, absolutely not. But I don't think so I can become one also. It's impossible. There is nothing like a perfect driver. But a careful, a safe driver is what I want to be. Okay, and I want to be safe for myself, the people who are with me, and the people who are around me. That's all I want to say. Okay. So next time you're on road, be very conscious. And just remember one thing, which I keep telling in all the other motor vlogs. Safety first, Shoki next. That's it. That's all I wanted to tell. I know it's a pretty lengthy video already, so I'll cut it short here. And probably we'll catch up again with one another topic on Jasmat Matali. So until then, bye-bye, take care, Mathe Siganam.